So I realized a couple days ago after I posted my behind the scenes, I would always forget something. And a lot of people have been commenting, hey, can you do a little bit more technical dive on how everything works? Like, you know, get into like techie nerdness of it. So that's what this video is gonna be. Here we go, let's go check it out.
Down in my basement, this is where everything starts. I've got my router set up and I got all my gear set up here. So let me go over these three pieces of gear that you're looking at here. The first one on the right, that's my internet router, and in the middle is my security gateway, and on my left is the 8-port router. So the internet comes into the internet router, so that's the outside world coming into that piece of gear there. That piece of gear connects to the security gateway that keeps me safe from the outside world. From the security gateway, that's connected to an 8-port router. And then from the 8-port router, that's where I have my various wireless access points. And that's also where the cable that connects to the Ethernet distro outside is. So the very last connection on that 8-port router, that's what goes outside and connects to my Ethernet distro.
So for my router that's down in my house, I've got that cable coming up and over my roof line here. It comes down and it's actually gonna come over here and terminate in one of my Cat5 distros that I built. So let me go take a look at that real quick. So once when the cable comes down, we plug it into this distro that I've built here. And in here, there is a 16-channel Cat5 switch that's in there. I've got 2 8-channels that are jumped together, and that gives me all 16 channels or 16 ports, my Cat5.
So let's take a look a little bit deeper into this Ethernet distro here. So the first cable I plug in is actually gonna be from the house, from that 8-port router. So that's the first thing I'm gonna plug in. The next thing that's plugged in is gonna be my Raspberry Pi. So now my Raspberry Pi is connected to everything in the house. Next will be my controller. So there's my 8 tiny reindeer, my 8 controllers that are in the yard, Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, and Blitzen. And then I'm also going to hook up a wireless access point outside. That's my long range access point that you'll see later on in the video. And that access point actually connects 5 more wireless controllers. So I've got Frosty and Grinch, and those run my Govies. And then I have 3 GLED Optos, and those run various things in my yard. I've got one that kind of runs a little window matrix. I've got one that runs some flowers in the front yard, and these were just kind of complete afterthoughts. They don't have Ethernet into them, so they're just wireless. So they're just little throwaway props there. So that's how the Ethernet distro is all connected.
So everything's hardwired into my actual router, into my home network, and that's how I get communication from my computer when I send it to the Falcon player. When the Falcon player sends out, that's how everything talks right there. So each one of these wires are labeled. This one's for Blitzen, that's Dancer, that's Comet, Prancer, so on and so forth. And my main line coming in, that's Santa Claus. That's the big fat man right there. So he comes in, so that's how everything talks. It comes into these switches and it talks to each other that way. That way everything is hard lined together. I do have some stuff that is wireless that I'll show you here in a second, but right now everything is all hardwired. So here, if we take a look at my mega tree, you can see this is where that line comes in. I've got this Cat5 that comes in here. This is Blitzen. It comes in, it feeds this controller, and then the controller, they're all built the same. So here's my Cat5 coming in, hits my Bong 69 controller, and that's what drives the data and the signal from the Falcon player and also from X-Lights. So everything's hardwired. They're all built the same, which is nice. So the brains behind the operation is my Raspberry Pi, which sits down here. So as I open my box here, again, another box, and in there is my Raspberry Pi that sits in here. It's connected via Cat5. And it's also got a sound blaster, which I'll leave the link for in the bottom, that runs the audio. So it's USB out, comes out to my 1/8-inch mini, and then that comes out to what I've done is an XLR cable, kind of like what you see a microphone cable. And that's what goes over to my FM transmitter. So I come out of my Pi here. You can kind of see it here. I'll plug it back in. So I come out of my Pi, there's my data coming in, and that's gonna take my audio out to my FM transmitter. Okay, so here we are in the corner of my house. We're gonna talk about the FM transmitter. So after it leaves the Raspberry Pi, the audio signal comes in, like I said, that via that XLR. So here's my XLR that's coming in. It comes into the input here. And if I open up my case here, I also have a build on this. Here's my FM transmitter. Comes in an 1/8-inch mini into here. There's my volume. I can select what channel it comes in. My antenna out, then exits out of the box. And I've populated that to the external part out here. And I use a 50-ohm cable to one of their giant dipole mega FM antennas that sits on my roof. So with everything that I'm running wireless, I wanna make sure that my Wi-Fi is really strong and really stout out here outside. Is that the wrong word for it? Is it stout? Should I not have said stout? Maybe not stout. Maybe stout's not the word. Just strong, go strong. So I use what's called the Ubiquiti. This is the model of the U6 LSR. So it's a long range series that is for my Wi-Fi. So I've got two of these. I got one on my front porch and one over by my garage, and it just kind of floods my whole area with just yummy, good Wi-Fi. So good Wi-Fi, good signals. A lot of the props I've made myself, this was before I discovered all the different companies that and all the vendors that sold them. So I went out and I bought some 4mm coroplast myself. And so if you come to the back here, let's take a look at the back. And in the back here, I've traced them all out. Yeah, come all the way around to the back over here. That's perfect. Yeah, all the way. So I've traced them out with a Sharpie, and each one I drilled out by hand. And I made them all out of seed pixels. So I'm gonna tell you what, that was a chore. And once when I found the companies that do it, I went ahead and started buying them because man, that is a time saver. But I made them all by hand. So behind here, let's come back in front. So behind here, I've got my candy canes. I've got my lollipops. My lollipops are basically just a simple circle with a pixel stake in it there. I've got my trees. Those were based off of the EFL trees. That was before I purchased them. I started making them. So I just kind of saw a picture of it and thought, hey, I could do that. And then I ended up making them. And man, that was a chore in itself there. These down here, my leaping arches, those are made out of, what is that made out of? I don't know what that's made out of. Oh, it's made out of PEX tubing. Yeah, that's it. PEX tubing. You get the 1/2-inch PEX tubing and you run your lights into there. And I've got a video on that. It looks great too. So that's my PEX tubing. Let's come up here to these over here. These were one of the first props that I purchased from EFL Designs. I like those guys. They always ship pretty quick. But this this was one of their just giant mega wreaths. It's 350 nodes. And this is a 10 mil corrugated plastic there. So that's 10 millimeter coroplast. That's good stuff there. Same thing up here with my snowflakes. Those are from EFL Designs. I like those a lot. The middle ones are from EFL Designs as well. And then we'll come over here to the left of my garage. And these are some I got from Gilbert Engineering this year. And these are the Seed Pixel snowflakes. I really like the Seed Pixel snowflakes. I'm starting to graduate everything over to Seed Pixels. Seed Pixels are just so much easier. They're so much lighter. I found that they're a lot more reliable than the Bullet Pixels. I'm not a fan of the Bullet Pixels much anymore. So all my stuff is gonna be Seed Pixels. So I got a few more props up here as well. These are all from Gilbert Engineering, except for the very top snowflake. That's from EFL Designs. Again, these are their Seed Pixels that I got from Gilbert Engineering down in Arizona. Those guys are great, and they look beautiful, they look wonderful, and I think they hold up just as well to the bullets as they do the seeds, so I don't see a difference in them. Of course, the bullet pixels are gonna be a little bit brighter, but everybody's running their show at 30% anyway, so I'm gonna kinda phase out of the bullets and put all seeds on my house. Okay, here's the stars of my show. This is Fern Flicker and Glow. This is Fern in the middle, and that's Flicker on the right, and this is Glow on the left. And Fern, she comes from EFL Designs. They shipped her out and shipped out her bow, and it's awesome. It's a 10 mil coroplast, really good quality. And the ones on the end, I actually made these. If you come up close, you can see how jagged and ragged this edge is. that I cut. This is one of my very first props I built, but man, it is awful. But at nighttime, no one can see it. And so so I made those. So those are based off of, I think either Boscoyo or Gilbert. I can't remember who makes those, but I mean, I'm seriously, it was like, I first made my arches and then I made these singing bulbs and I cut them all by hand. It was a lot of work. But anyway, so those are my two singers, my three singers there. And then I got one up on top of the garage. It's my old man. And I got him from Gilbert Engineering. So that's a Gilbert Engineering bulb up there. So last but not least, this is my mega tree. I had it custom built, the frame on the bottom. I've got a buddy that's a welder and a pipe bender and a metal worker. And so he made the base for me. And I got a video I'm gonna show you guys on that when I build that. But we did the base. I got the stand from a yard sale. It was like 10 bucks. It was fantastic. It worked out great. It's a big, huge Matthews Studio like light stand that they use for, I don't know, movie projection and film, stuff like that. And then on the very top, it looks like the wind has taken my star. Let's go this way so we can see it. I'll have to boost my star back over. But that star is a pixel seed star, and that is from Gilbert Engineering. And it's great, and it looks beautiful up there. So there you have it. There's the technical side of how everything's connected. I hope you guys learned a little bit. Make sure you hit that like and subscribe button down below. And thanks for coming back to the channel. If you guys have any questions, let me know. But yeah, it's pretty good. Oh, hey, there's my giant antenna on the top up there. And some, I don't know, there's a dog out there. He's running around. It's great. Good technical stuff.